last month, I'd never have made it. But my doctor gave me a birth control pill called Yaz. I told her how I was an emotional wreck a week or so before my period. I thought I had PMS, so I tracked my symptoms, and my doctor told me that's not PMS, that's PMDD.
Oh, I love this commercial.
Would you guys try NuvaRing?
I'm not even sure what it is.
It is a monthly vaginal birth control ring that delivers a low dose of hormones.
Don't you have to put it in?
For me, it's easy. You put NuvaRing in for 3 weeks, you take it out, and then you put a new one in 7 days later.
I can handle that.
Small and comfortable. Plus, you don't have to take it every day.
That's nice.
But I'm already on the pill.
I know.
Right? So was I until I talked to my doctor about switching. NuvaRing is just as effective.
Really?
The morning after your birth control fails, you might think you're alone. Guess what? You're not the first. You won't be the last. Be calm. Go directly to Plan B. Plan B is emergency contraception that helps prevent pregnancy after birth control failure or unprotected sex. It's a backup plan and should not be used as regular birth control. With Plan B, you don't need a prescription if you're 18 or over. You have 72 hours to prevent pregnancy. The sooner you take it, the better it works.
Serious risks include blood clots, stroke, or heart attack. NuvaRing is not for women with a history of these conditions. Some studies suggest that the progestin in NuvaRing may increase the risk for blood clots. Smoking increases cardiovascular risks, especially in women over 35. NuvaRing users should not smoke. NuvaRing also is not for women with certain cancers or those who may be pregnant. It does not protect against HIV and other STDs.
So you'd recommend it?
I would.
Maybe it's time I ask my doctor about it.
You should.
Talk to your doctor about trying NuvaRing today.
Would you take a prescription if you knew one of the side effects was possibly death? That's the question being asked tonight about one of the most popular birth control drugs on the market and the subject of a recent bombshell Vanity Fair story titled Danger in the Ring. Young, healthy women by the thousands have reported dangerous side effects. Some have died. Tonight, a Valley family featured in that article is on a mission to get some answers.
44 million prescriptions filled, 4,000 lawsuits filed, 224 deaths in question. Among those, 24-year-old Erica Langhart. Erica had traveled the world and worked for two U.S. senators, including John McCain. She was getting ready to begin law school at Georgetown when her parents got the phone call.
It's like the world stopped, as it'll never be the same. from that moment on.
She suffered 4 heart attacks that night.
Rick and Karen Langhart rushed to Washington, D.C. They say their daughter, who had no prior history of health problems, suffered a blood clot so massive it completely clogged her lungs.
The doctor, when we showed up at the hospital, came out and told us directly that your daughter suffered the pulmonary embolisms from the NuvaRing.
Symptoms of PMDD are severe enough to actually interfere with your life.
It's on the Yaz website.
DRSP is a different kind of hormone that may increase potassium, so you shouldn't take Yaz if you have kidney, liver, or adrenal disease because this could cause serious heart and health problems. Tell your doctor if you're on daily long-term treatment for a chronic condition like cardiovascular disease or chronic inflammatory disease. The pill does not protect against HIV or STDs. Serious risks include blood clots, stroke, and heart attack, so women especially over 35 shouldn't smoke because it increases these risks.
Wow, you really know your stuff.
I didn't go to medical school for nothing.
Show off.
Seriously, track your symptoms, talk to your doctor, and ask if Yaz is right for you.
Side effects may include nausea, abdominal pain, fatigue, headache, or changes in your period. If your period is more than 1 week late, you may be pregnant. If you have severe abdominal pain, seek immediate medical help. Sometimes the unexpected happens. If it does, there's Plan B.
It was what I would call a born humanitarian. I don't like to see people suffer. I don't like to see cruelty, even to this day. And in nursing, you see a great deal of cruelty and unnecessary suffering. A certain satisfaction in doing something that was going to alleviate the sufferings of women in particular. And I was quite a feminist at the time.
Mm-hmm, obviously.
And, yes. And I naturally didn't want to see women take all the suffering of childbearing and of pregnancies.
Do you believe in sin? When I say believe, I don't mean in believe in committing sin. Do you believe there is such a thing as sin?
Well, I think the greatest sin in the world is bringing children into the world that have disease from their parents, that have no chance in the world to be a human being, practically. Delinquents, prisoners, all sorts of things, just marked when they're born. That, to me, is the greatest sin that people can